Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for attending this session. My name is Yusuke Goda from Renesas. Today, and I'm going to talk about Accelerate Open Source Community Development for Automotive Industry on Arca Board. So let's get started. In this session, there are two speakers, I and Inami-san. I will talk first half, and then Inami-san will talk second half. So let me introduce ourselves simply. I have been working at Renesas for 10 plus years, and I'm responsible for development of Arca low-cost board series. Gak Inami has been working at Renesas for 6 years, and he's responsible for software marketing for Arca SoC series. Today's agenda. First topic is recent trend of EE architecture and consortium's contribution to automotive development. Second topic is Renesas' proposal for accelerating automotive industry consortium's development. The last topic is detailed components of proposal and expected use case. This slide shows the evolution of EE architecture. As you may know, EE architecture is evolving from distributed architecture to centralized and zonal architecture. In distributed architecture, each MCU and function allocation is distributed. There was still room for improvement. On the other hand, in centralized and zonal architecture, there are four requirements: SDV realization, architecture simplification, harness and Arca weight reduction, and fuel electricity improvement. That's the reason why its architecture would transit that ECU function are consolidated and physical allocation is optimized. However, such transition is not easy. For example, if ECU is consolidated into one chip, multiple features are mixed. So it needs the isolation mechanism and also consistency for software architecture, policy, configuration, etc. As an example, software update feature is needed for SDV. However, it's not easy to create the mechanism in different architecture and different ECUs. In those cases, new design implementation may be required. Therefore, to achieve these requirements, system becomes more and more complex. And software development cost is increasing rapidly. That's a serious issue for OEM. To reduce the cost of software development in the future, it needs to separate competitive area and non-competitive area in software structure. Then, non-competitive areas should be commonized. In order to do that, common specification to across different OEM and different tier one is needed to define. As such background, many consortiums were organized to make common or new architecture. These consortiums, AGL and COBISA and so on, are just examples. There are also many other organizations. And then, in fact, each consortium already contributes car product with using its asset and effort. However, there are some blocking factors to accelerate consortium's activity. From the hardware point of view, the lack of reference hardware variation. It means few low-cost boards dedicated for gateway having rich interface. Then it's difficult for consortium engineers to purchase. As a result, engineer cannot try feasibility study on reference board with their idea. Second one is the lack of real-time OS for vehicle control from software point of view. It means few other compliant OSS-based real-time OS. Then it's difficult for consortium engineers to develop. Due to solve these factors, Renesas propose new solution in this session. In hardware side, we provide R-Car S4 starter kit. It's lowest priced board for gateway, which can reduce BOM costs by integrating the MCU and SoC into one. In software side, we provide R-Car S4 white box SDK. All software is free of charge, and application software, real-time software, MCU software, all software are integrated into one package. In addition, by the combination of software and hardware, it realizes high accessibility as synergy. It means anyone can start with low cost soon, and it's useful for both MCU and SoC engineers. And we believe this can accelerate consortium's development. Okay. So moving on more details, next slide for each. R-Car S4 starter kit, hardware part. First of all, I will introduce the R-Car S4 SoC briefly before explaining the R-Car S4 starter kit. R-Car S4 product concept is designed to meet the needs of the next generation gateway market. Concept 1, build-in MCU function. Monolithic chip design, including both MCU and SoC IP to make the best combination of MCU and SoC features. Concept 2, rich communication interfaces. Supporting various interfaces such as 16 channels CAN FD, 16 units RIM, 1 channel FlexRay, and multi gigabit Ethernet, etc. These have realized to reduce the BOM cost and size on customer side. This is the block diagram of ARCA S4 SoC. Just to highlight here the new features compared with the former ARCA Gen 3 and MCU in orange. ARCA S4 is composed of 8 ARM Cortex-A55 for application cores, offering 27 kilo DMIPS and 1 ARM Cortex-R52 for real-time core, and G4MH for microcontroller system. And it offers 4-lane PCIe, 3-port gigabit Ethernet switch, CAN FD, LIN, etc. as communication interfaces. In addition, 12 nano process technology to achieve extreme low power consumption paired with high compute and support HLD. And incorporated 8 megabyte SRAM to execute code on the G4MH core with low latency. The best feature of ARCA S4 is that it reuses ARCA Gen 3 and MCU IP to achieve 88% software reusability. This allows customers to reduce software and benefit from lower development costs and faster time to market. This is the ARCA S4 starter kit board, equipped with the ARCA S4 SoC, which is suitable for gateway evaluation. It's easy to use, so anyone can download software and document without a contract. It's easy to use, so anyone can evaluate the ARCA S4 immediately using open source software. It's easy to buy, so anyone can buy it from distributors. ARCA S4 starter kit is a small, low cost, easily available development board for building software using the Renesas ARCA S4 SoC. User can take advantages of the new kit to easily start their initial evaluation of automotive gateway systems for Rabbit application development. Here is the ARCA SO starter kit specification. SOC is ARCA S4. DRAM is 4 GB LPDDR4. Flash memory is equipped with 64 MB QSPI and 128 GB UFS. 1 micro SD card slot, 2 channels Ethernet TSN, and 1 channel Ethernet AVV. Debug serial is 2 port. PCIe is 2 channels, root complex and endpoint. CAN FD is 2 channels. LIN is 1 channel. User LED and user switch are each 3 pieces. Supported CPU core column shows which CPU core can access each function. For example, the Ethernet AVV, CAN FD, LIN, User LED and user switch functions are accessible by G4MH. This slide shows link information. All information about ARCA S4 Starter Kit is available from GE Linux Wiki and Renesas ARCA S4 Starter Kit product page. At first, I briefly explain eLinux Wiki page. We prepared 4 pages on eLinux website. Board information, Yocto Linux, Zen Hypervisor, and Zephyr. Board information page is available with board specifications and how to flash loaders, etc. And we have prepared the Renesas BSP ROM writer as a loader flash tool. The flash tool and many other useful information can be found on this page. So please visit board information page. Yocto Linux, Zen Hypervisor, Zephyr pages are available with how to build, how to boot, and examples of access to each function, etc. Please refer to these pages when implementing each operating system. And we will continue to expand these pages. So please refer to them regularly. Board manual, ARCA S4 configuration tool, and ICU MX loader can be downloaded from ARCA S4 Starter Kit product page. ARCA S4 Starter Kit configuration tool can control SOC mode configuration, power configuration, peripheral configuration, dip switch, etc. Please refer to the board manual and eLinux page for more information about configuration tool. This slide shows the history of ARCA Starter Kit and our activities for AGL. We launched the ARCA Starter Kit series in 2014. ARCA Gen 2 Portable, ARCA Gen 3 Starter Kit, and Kingfisher Expansion Board have adapted as reference platform for AGL. As well as these boards, we aim to adapt the ARCA S4 Starter Kit as a reference platform for AGL. Where to buy? Shimafuji Electric sells the ARCA S4 Starter Kit for worldwide. The price is roughly $1,000. And we are negotiating with some global distributors to start sales by end of the year. Please give us just a bit more time. The latest status can be found on the ARCA S4 Starter Kit product page. We will announce when global distributors start selling. Next, Inami-san will explain ARCA S4 white box. Inami-san, please.
Thank you, Goda-san. Hello, my name is Gaku Inami. I'm going to explain second half. Whitebox SDK is developed by Renesas, and we named it Whitebox because all source code and specification are published. Whitebox SDK has five features. First feature is accessible. All software is published on GitHub, and there is no license fee. Therefore, anytime, anywhere, anyone can access the source code with no restriction. Second feature is customizable. It does not include a binary and proprietary software in Whitebox SDK. All of source code software code can be modified by users. Third feature is extensible. Whitebox SDK is developed based on Yoct project. And, so any packages can be added or removed by modifying the recipe file. Fourth feature is flexible. Three real-time OS are supported. Topaz ATK2 and Trampoline OS are compliant Authzar, and Zephyr OS will support ACL certification. User can select each OS and depending on usage and environment. The last feature is use case oriented. In past, software package provided by Renesas does not include middleware and application. When user tried some use case like OTA, user needed to prepare software by themselves. In Whitebox SDK, middleware and application are pre-implemented, so user can try it without adding this software by themselves. Then, moving on software structure of Whitebox SDK in next slide. This slide shows use case and the software structure in Whitebox SDK. Please look at this figure from top side, use case, software block, and hardware block are divided. And the software block is separated by three layers. In addition, left side is a vehicle control domain, and the right side is the vehicle service domain. So let's look at vehicle control domain in left side. Main use cases are CAN control and Ethernet communication, and the required software are implemented. As you see, current software stack is minimum implementation. So we will add more application based on customer requirements. Then, regarding to support OS, there are three OS. First one is Topaz ATK2 and SafeG Auth. Their users are almost a Japanese consortium and its engineer for MCU products. We integrated this OS for their purpose. Second one is Trampoline OS. We are interested in this OS because Trampoline OS is compliant Autosar, and it can be working on heterogeneous core, G4MH, and Cortex-R52. I think this OS would be useful for POC development and benchmark measurement. Also, we already started upstream for it. The last one is Zephyr. We integrated this OS because there are many users and many features. If you want to have ASIL certification support, it's better to choose Zephyr OS. Next, let's look at vehicle service domain in right side. There are many use cases, OTA firmware update, the collection of vehicle information, security feature, resource monitoring. Major use case can be covered. I think many consortium and engineers are considering Linux-based services. I accept their service can be added in the future. Then, all software stack on this figure are open source and published on GitHub. And we will upstream each software module for each community and project with experience of white box SDK. So moving on white box SDK GitHub in next slide. Left screen capture is the top page of white box SDK GitHub. Basically, all of the necessary information is described on this page. Let me explain for each of them. At first, about files and directory allocation. There are some directory for each CPUs and source file, config file, recipe file, and so on are stored in each directory. Also, build scripts are stored in tool directory. Next, branch information. The latest branch of white box SDK is v5.x at this moment. And then we are publishing demo environment with white box SDK. Its branch is demo v2. Next, we also prepared dedicated white box SDK page on Renesas website. Documentation and video contents and so on can be downloaded in this site. I will explain how to download and build. Download the repository by repo init. And install some packages. Install some packages for toolchain. Set up environment by shell script. Then just exec build. Also, let me add one more thing. As I explained in previous slide, multiple OS are supported in vehicle control domain. When you build along these steps, the firmware image of 3OS are deployed. And you will think this procedure is very simple. But it takes a long time with full build because there are a lot of modules. And we do not provide a build image because image size is too large. This slide shows documentation and support. We prepared three documentations. First one is user's manual. It describes a feature list and the way to flash and boot. Second one is application note. It describes the way to use the way to use application along use case. The last one is demo startup guide. We created a basic demo environment with white box SDK. Then I introduce it in this session later. This demo environment is also published, and it describes the way to set up. Next is FAQ site. If you have any questions, you can find similar questions on this site. Next is QA forum. Lunesas prepared a forum site to discuss ARCA S4 starter kit and white box SDK. And Lunesas engineers and our partners are already joined on this forum. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to post it. Let me introduce case study. This slide shows the expected use case with using ARCA S4 starter kit and white box SDK. Basically, a consortium is working by individual working group so far. For example, Meta Cluster and IVI, each feature has been considered and developed and evaluated on single ECU. Now, by adding ARCA S4 gateway solution, the use case variation would be more extended. Meta cluster and IVI and gateway are connected. Then several services, vehicle to cloud, OTA firmware update, VSS, and so on, would be easier to use. This example is still my assumption, but I think it would be better to discuss more detail in each consortium and working group. Anyway, let's start the use case of new architecture across multiple ECUs. Let me introduce today's demo. Sorry. this event, we are showcasing the demo with ArcGIS for Starter Kit and Whitebox SDK. The demo scenario is a mixed use case. Multiple demo are consolidated into one demo environment. At this time, you can see multiple OTA firmware update and network routing and resource monitoring. Let me introduce an example scenario with using video about 4 minutes. Its scenario is OTA demo. Let me show the video. Just a moment.
This demo comprises ArcGIS 4 as the central gateway, ArcGIS H3 as the meter cluster, ArcGIS H850U2A as the domain controller, a simulator for generating vehicle information, and an OTA server. This demo will feature meter cluster and OTA, over the air, use cases. Firstly, let's take a look at the meter cluster data flow. The ArcGIS S4 route simulator generated vehicle information such as speed and engine RPM to the ArcGIS H3. The meter cluster operates on the ArcGIS H3 based on this routed information and outputs it to the cluster screen. Next, let's look at the OTA data flow. The ArcGIS S4 receives update files from the OTA server. The received update file is deployed by the ArcGIS S4 to the OTA target device. The actual devices are configured like this. OTA server, simulator, ArcGIS H850U2A, alcohol sensor, ArcGIS S4, ArcGIS H3, cluster screen. In this demo, the hardware functions are enabled by using FOTA for the plugged-in hardware. As explained earlier, the vehicle information generated by the simulator is routed by the ArcGIS S4 and the ArcGIS H3 outputs the meter cluster to the screen. In this case, an alcohol sensor is used as the plugged-in hardware. Of course, other additional hardware could be added, including radar and other sensors. Simply plugging in the alcohol sensor does not activate the function of the alcohol sensor. So it is not possible to acquire data from the alcohol sensor. To activate the alcohol sensor function, the firmware of the domain controller must be updated. The update file for FOTA is uploaded to the OTA server from this screen. When the upload succeeds, a component will be generated. Next, in validation batch details, FOTA execution is approved for the component just generated. In unit details, users can check status messages of executed FOTA, such as downloading and installing. Once the vendor version has been updated, it means the firmware has been successfully deployed. Completing the firmware update for the domain controller activates the function of the alcohol sensor. Data acquired by the alcohol sensor is sent to ArcGIS H3 via ArcGIS S4. Information obtained by the alcohol sensor is added to the cluster screen, and the warning alcohol detected is displayed when the alcohol concentration exceeds the threshold. In this way, AOS Edge makes it possible to utilize FOTA and expand functions easily.
And to end our presentation, I would like to summarize today's key points. Introduction, expanding the consortium's activity in non-competitive area for software cost reduction. Proposal, combination with archives for starter kit and Whitebox SDK to realize high accessibility. Goal, accelerating the expansion of consortium's development with our proposal. If you are interested in this proposal, please try to use it. That's all our presentation. Thank you so much, everyone.
<笑>質問があれば受けますけれども、どなたがいらっしゃいますか And,、does anyone have any question? No?
Thank you so much.